long time. He's been mentioned with the baddest men on the planet for a long time, though. The title fight eluded him. Not anymore. Here he is, the number one heavyweight contender, finally making this walk and cracking a smile. He's waited a long time for this. He's not expecting a 25-minute war. He believes he has the power and the skills to get this thing done quickly. I guess we'll find out. So here he is making his way to the octagon for another heavyweight title defense. This has been the baddest man on the planet now for several years, and he has taken on all comers more often than not, leaving them twitching on the canvas. Knockout power for days. The question is tonight, with a challenge like this, can he walk out the way he came in as the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world? Event of the evening. Jones is 3 years his senior. He will have an 8-inch reach advantage. And now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Bergliata. And now, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting! Out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'7" tall, weighing in at 254 pounds. Fighting out of San Diego, California, presenting the challenger, Iceman. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a look-see do fighter, holding a professional record of 27 wins, 1 loss, and 1 no contest. He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 225 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, USA, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC Heavyweight Champion of the World, John Bones Jones.
They touch him up, and we are underway. All right, so here we go with the start of round one. I can tell how excited you are for this matchup. Seems to be a striking advantage on one side, but maybe.
This is a big-time fight. It feels like a big moment for both of these guys' careers. Who is going to be able to...
Oh!
That's how you finish a fight.
He's got him hurt here. Oh, looked like he might have been in range, but misses with the kick. Oh! Well, that won't feel good in the morning. Big uppercut. Jab by him there, really taking advantage of what is an obvious edge and reach. Frost gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Oh, nice. Look at the angle of that nice body kick.
Oh, nice connection there by John Jones. And he is fighting with a definite killer instinct here tonight, DC.
And you have to have it, because the target's always on your back when you're the UFC champion. Jones seems destined to keep that title wrapped around the waist. Big, powerful punch land. Now we get back to range.
Lunges forward with a left there. And there comes the separation now. Back to the left hand now, unable to connect. Just over 2 minutes to go. Oh, nice jab by him there, and I guess on the other side, hard to get your offense going when your head keeps getting snapped back like a Pez dispenser.
Every time he tries to go forward and use his own offense, the jab is stopping him in his tracks. He's doing a great job of fighting behind him.
Submission defense there.
Nice punch lands over the top. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Straight right hand, no good. Nice defense there. Huge block. Seconds to go. Jones going with the kick to the body, but unable to find the range. Right now, we check out some of the action from that previous round, DC. How about the display of striking?
Just high level. I mean, you would think that we're watching a K1 level kickboxing match opposed to being in the UFC. Both displayed great technical skills, unbelievable striking.
Okay, you ready, round two? Ready?
All right, second round underway. Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that land, DC. And he landed the right hand there. All right, so a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
All right, so he's landed some good shots tonight, but this is not a combo meal, right? No three-piece, no soda. It's one and done more often than not.
John, don't you come to me without a combo. I want the whole platter. Give him the whole platter, young man. Put some punches together. Make this guy take the whole thing. Give him more than one strike. You have now found a setup punch. The jab is landing consistently. Find something that's going to go behind it.
Get him tall. One, two, three.
Oh, nice job to get the guard up there as the strike is blocked by Frost. Stuffs the takedown. No problem. Much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
And they separate. Oh, nice goal. Frost gets hit by that leg kick. Just out of range with that left hook. Jones's kick to the body, that one blocked. So the numbers continuing to pile up here. 33 total strikes have landed for John Jones. Well, not the greatest land percentage necessarily. 37% the accuracy thus far against John Jones. Oh, Jones gets hit with a kick here. That one landed flush. Let's see if he can make some adjustments. Nice job by Johnny Bones there on the feet. I'm not in the prediction business, but if the opponent doesn't adjust here, this could be the beginning of the end.
He's got to do something different. Because for Jones, he's not only a diverse striker, but he's a fantastic finisher. He's a guy that when he gets the opponents hurt, he knows where to find the spot in their night.
Sound defense there as he blocks the shot. Oh, that's a strong slip there, and then the rip. A swing and a miss by Johnny Bone. 10 seconds remain in round two. Round three next. A lot of high-level striking action in that last round. Daniel, take us through it, if you will.
Tit for tat. Who has the best chin? It seemed as though they were looking for that answer. Both guys took risk. What a fantastic round.
Here we go with this third round of this championship fight. Well, just as he did the previous round, continuing to land a high number of strikes here, and he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down. Scary, scary proposition for the opponent.
Ooh, head kick lands. Hurt.
Big hook. Straight punch there. Must be nice to have a reach advantage like this, DC. Oh! Right up the gut, DC. He's in a world of trouble now.
They say the great ones are the ones that get there first, and it got right to the target.
All right, single collar tie now. Mixes it up nicely into. Oh! He's out!
He's done!
A near-perfect strike to end the fight and end the night for his opponent, who candidly may not have even seen that shot coming. So just the way he threw it up, exactly what he told us during fight week, played out here on fight night. He found a little opening in his opponent's defense and barged right through it to get the big knockout win. So the celebration is on for the UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the baddest man on the planet, and your winner, yes, by knockout here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bermiotti has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 26 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout and boom! Undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Iceman!
Well, DC, you know how much I love crowning new champions, yeah. And when we get to see these men and women realize these dreams. But to do it at heavyweight, man, just incredible to see this guy realize a UFC title.
And you look at the emotion on his face. You can tell that this is a dream that he has had for a long time, and now it is realized. Congratulations to the champ and his entire team.